Today we're going to paint a damselfly on eelgrass on the lake, and we're using the Daniel Smith Floral Cottage Gardens to Botanical set. And here's our little paint box. What I'm going to do is wet down a piece of paper, and all I have is a water mister. And I'm going to do both sides so that it doesn't curl. Now for this project, I'm going to use Phthalo Blue to start with. There, I just need to tip some water off. So, Phthalo Blue. I wanted a very light value. Bleed down, and a darker value on the bottom. And I'll let it dry before I do the next step. Now I happen to have one that's already done and dried. So I'll use it, and we're going to do our damselfly. We'll need the size 2 brush for that, and again the Phthalo Blue, we want a really dark value. I'm just pushing down and lifting up. I need to wiggle this one a little bit because a damselfly has a wee bit that's thicker there. Going to do one, we may as well do two. This one's a little further away, so we'll just change the value of that one. And we'll need to put it on a blade of grass, so let's use that Cascade green. That is a beautiful green. There's a real talent to mixing greens, and this one just does the job for you. I want to make sure that it's a wet, juicy brush so that I can make it to the top of the blade of grass. Let's just say it starts here. Let's charge that grass with a little tiny bit of cadmium yellow. Just put some life into it. And I'm going to mix a neutral. And a neutral means opposite ends of the color wheel. So that would be red and green. The color wheel's a discussion for another day. So, damselflies have really pretty wings. They're very soft. So I'm just going to pull that out. I might join it together once it's dry. So I'll go back into my Phthalo Blue. And make some ripples. Usually there's a little shadow or a reflection. I might even use some of that neutral. I'll go to a larger brush. Some of that move around. That neutral color is so pretty. Thirsty brush on the edges. And and we're done.